It could be so small, and yet it could save a life. A Toronto subway, the message to commuters, just say hi.
A simple human contact, that's all we're really asking is if you see somebody that looks upset, just reach out to them and say, how's it going today?
The new initiative is part of the Toronto Transit Commission's suicide prevention strategy.
Can't believe this weather.
Research in the UK has found small talk.
Is everything all right?
Can break a deadly impulse and set someone on a path to recovery. So far in 2019, there have been 21 suicide attempts that resulted in 9 deaths on Toronto subway.
What we're trying to do is broaden the net. We've got TTC employees in stations, we've got our special constables, our fare inspectors, we've got janitors and lots of people there, but they're not everywhere and they're not all the time everywhere. And so we're trying to reach out and ask customers to lend a hand, to be the one to save the life.
Asking commuters to help also comes with a plan for when they can't. Mental health volunteers will now be on hand after a suicide incident to help traumatized witnesses.
The day after, because people tend to have certain schedules, so they may return at the same time. So that's what we're trying to do, is have people there around the same time as it occurred the day before.
And what would you be offering?
Emotional support. And whatever resources that we think they may need or that they may ask for.
The goal behind all this is to break the silence and the stigma around suicide and to frame it as a preventable tragedy. But there is always a fear of triggering copycats.
We want to be open about mental health and about suicide.
The suicide expert is helping the TTC find the right tone.
People who are suicidal are vulnerable and vulnerable to messaging, and we have to make sure that we get the right message out, which is that there is hope and that people care.
That is the message here, and so is the hope, that commuters realize they can do so much to save a life with so little. Ioanna Roumelitos, CBC News, Toronto.